Welcome to my very first YouTube video. As you know from the title, I will show you how I drew Mew in space in this video. Small disclaimer, this is not going to be a tutorial. I just want to show you what I did, but feel free to do the same. So as you can see, I taped a piece of watercolor paper directly on a glass table. And the good thing about this is you can clean every mess very easily. And to activate the watercolor, I put a drop of water into every tiny color potty I planned to use. I wanted to create a very dark background, so you are going to see me applying multiple coats of color. And I started very light with strongly watered down colors on the dry paper. And I just put them randomly all over the place. Yeah, I waited after each layer until the paper dried completely from its own. You could use a dryer to speed the process up, but I didn't. I waited. there were some feathering paint all over the paper where I used so much water that the pigment didn't soak into it, but it stayed on top. I used these feathered contours to guide me to put the next layer on color on top of these. So you can draw an advantage out of everything. So for this step I used slightly less water to intensify the pigment. Yeah, and I continued this step until there were no feathering anymore and until I thought it would be dark enough. Yeah, there I thought that the lightest parts were too light for me, because I wanted it very, very, very dark. So I added some more color to that too. I always have an additional piece of paper in front of me to try out the color before I put it on the actual painting, and I have paper towels to take away the excess water. Maybe I'm going to switch to a cotton towel in the future, but we will see. There are advantages and disadvantages of both of them. As you can also see, I just use one cup of water all the time. Normally you need two. One to free the brush from paint and one to water the paint in the tin. But I'm lazy and I combined the colors anyway all the time with each other, so I just kept one. And I didn't need to get the colors separated as strong as possible for this painting, so yeah. Yeah, there you can see that I used the paper towel to get rid of too much paint and too much water. You could do this just as you feel. And so you can see I get darker and darker with always the same colors. I didn't use any black with this, it's just blues and reds and the combination of them. And I was by myself surprised how dark it really could get. I don't know if all watercolors are able to do this, but Schminke Akademie can, obviously. And I think if you add all the colors on top on each other to get this dark instead of using just black, creates a much smoother and nicer overlayering effect at the end, I think. And at the wet stage you can't see it directly, but after each layer that dries, it comes more obvious. the red, if you just add the red, it could not get that that dark. So the darkest I could get, how I said, with the blues and the red in combination. I mixed the colors on the paper directly. The surface was so big that I kind of use it as itself as a palette. I think that was the last layering you can see there, or the last layer I'm putting down. You can see that it almost looks black at the darkest areas. Yeah, the paper I use is nothing special. I don't think it is even 100% cotton, but it did a very great job for this painting. Time for the stars. I used the toothbrush for this the dentist gave me for free at my last visit. Just put some acrylic paint on it and water it down so you can get very tiny sprinkles. There we have it. Time to change the water cup for the first time all along. So yes, it's alright. The paint got all over the table too, but I really love how the stars are bringing the space to life. With it watered down, you can get really, really fine effects. If you get too excited with this, you could get some streaky points. Maybe you should try it if you do this the first time on another sheet of paper. But it's very messy and also some kind of easy, so don't worry too much. Yeah, and I used this paper the first time, so I didn't know how it would handle this torture I put it through, but it handled it pretty well, and just the tape was too strong for it and it got ripped a bit. For the next time, I think I will try out something else, whether another tape or just other paper, we'll see. Yeah, there you can see how it ripped a bit. But yeah, what do you think? Next, I sketched Mew from a reference picture from PokéWiki on a very cheap printer paper. It really doesn't matter which kind or what kind of paper you use, because it's just to transfer the drawing to the galaxy painting to not ruin it by erasing any mistakes you could make. Just a rough sketch to get all the proportions as you like. And then to transfer it to the galaxy painting, I flipped the sketch and scribbled with a very soft pencil. In this case it's an 8B all over the back, and then I cut it out and taped the whole thing where I wanted it to be. Yeah, sketchy, sketchy. So, and there I taped it where I wanted it to be. No, first I cut it. There I cut it. I should have thought about to tape the sketch to the background too, and not just to the table, so it would stay at its place. But luckily it didn't slip away that much while I transferred the sketch. It could have been worse. But you, if you want to imitate me, just think about that. Yeah, there I checked that there got some slippery there. That I didn't tape it enough. Yeah, here I'm trying to show you how it looks in the light, so that I know where to put the paint down next. Here I used gouache to give me a light base over the dark background. I just mixed white with some red tones together to get a rosy white mixture. And I just used the Schminke gouache for this. I have to say I was surprised how liquidy this gouache was. Can you tell me if this is normal or if it is just this brand? But I think the advantage of this is that it dries very flat, matte and opaque anyways, so it could be a nice base for the next medium I was going to use. And here you have some real time, so you can see how slowly I actually drew this. Yeah, and so because this was so liquidy, I tapped the color more down than I made brush strokes to get it opaque enough. I didn't paint the areas where I planned to outline you anyways. So now let's speed up this process. You see that it got quite patchy. I didn't mind that. For me it was enough to cover everything with pencils in the next step. I could have used another layer of this to get a smoother layering, but I didn't want to build up too much color. I wasn't even sure if the paper would handle this much layering. Now I used the colored pencils from Polychromos. I first tried to get to know what I could achieve at maximum on the head. So I did the head at once. I tried to get the highlights with just the white pencil, and so you can see that the pencils are not opaque enough to get a really bright shine in the eyes. So I didn't film this, but I painted with a white jelly pen over this to make the eyes really shine. But there you can see that it is that the step with the white gouache was necessary to bring the very light pink of Mew's skin color to shine. So when I was quite satisfied with the result of the head, I continued to put a base pinkish layer on the rest of the body. I added the shadows and blended everything with the white and the pink pencil after all of that together. For the shadows I used some purplish colors. And as you can see, I did not achieve an absolute smooth texture nor a very smooth blending, but I think that Mew looks like this much more live, and I like it this way better. If you would like to get it much smoother though, anyways, you should add more layers and don't push the pencil too hard too early as I did. I think although there are so many layers of watercolor and gouache, I surely think that it would possible to do it this way and get a very smooth surface and very smooth blending. And yeah, when I got a feeling for how hard I was able to put the pencil down, the paper could handle it. As a last step, I added the contours with a simple black pencil. I could have used a dark violet or even a white to make Mew pop out more from the background, but I didn't. I wanted to use a black pencil. Yeah, and there we have the result. I hope you liked what you've seen, and some comments down below, and that other stuff you could do to support YouTubers would be nice. So till the next video, bye! Bye bye, bye bye, bye bye, bye.